this video, we are going to see how they made maps or handle from HTML and decisions are taken. Here the image maps can be done in PHP, that is image coordinates. Image can be made to display in the HTML site, and when the user presses a particular place in that image, based on the coordinates in which the user presses, a decision can be done or a redirection to another website can be done. So in this, there is no need for submit button. If the user presses, that itself is considered as a submit. So clicking the image itself sends that the location of that click the image to the server. So in the following program, which we are going to see in this example, we are going to display a street signal image. So the user is asked to click where and all the street signals are present. The image is given in terms of squares, and the top left corner x and y and bottom right and right x and y coordinates are defined for each square. When the user click within this and street signal is present, the program responds that the user has clicked the appropriate square, or it responds that the user has not clicked the proper square. So we will see the program. This HTML part where we have used post method, and we call it, we send the data to phpimage.php. Now click the image. Here how you can display the images by using the input tag and name equal to, we have given a variable name for that image to be displayed. Then type, when we give type image, now it is ready to display an image. And using the control src, we have to give the name of the file, image file. So remember that this should be in your working folder, or you have to give the full path name from where this file is present. Now the next part is PHP. So when the user clicks it, it will send that coordinates, x and y coordinates, to this phpimage.php. Now we'll see what we are doing here. We are just reading that by using the $request, and the variable name _x will give you the x coordinate. Same way, the variable name. This is the variable name which we have used here. So variable name, whatever variable name we are using, _x will give you the x coordinates. Same way, _y will give you the y coordinates. Then we are assigning that to some local variable, x and y. And we are printing it on the screen. Then we define the x and based on the x and y coordinates, we say whether the user has pressed a signboard or not. Now, if it is not within these squares, then you press somewhere else. Now we'll see, we'll execute this program and see that. So when you execute the PHP image map.html, so this image is displayed. This you should have seen in Google verification and all. Press the signboard in order so you are not a robot. So here I am pressing this. This is the signboard. Already in coding we have given, you have said this x and y coordinate. Okay, x coordinate from here to here, because these are all squares. So from here to here I have taken, and from here this is a y coordinate, this and this I have taken. So if it is within that, then user has pressed the signboard. If he has pressed this, he has not pressed the signboard. That is what the idea. So now I give this, you press the signboard. Now let us see that again. Now I press here, it is not the signboard. See, you press somewhere else, it prints the x and y coordinate. Okay, press this. Yes, you press somewhere else, because it is not a signboard. This is only this thing. Maybe the coding can be modified. Here I press this, you press the signboard. Yes. Now if I press here, shares somewhere else. Okay. We do this. If you press somewhere else. Now, let's see, press the send. So in the coding, if I want this also, this also to be the mentioned as signboard, then I have to do some modification. I have to find the x and y coordinate, and that has to be included in our if class. So we have given like this x, and if it is giving this, y is between this, then you press the signboard. The simple logic.